Dear ladies and gentlemen, in the background you can see a tree, neither a bush nor a flower, it's a tree, as you can see. Some of today's physicists have the opinion that since the 1970s, nothing new has been found out in elementary physics. This is not true. Dr. Rüdiger Goltz has made fundamental discoveries to change the current research line dramatically concerning atomic physics. First of all, he has found out that there is a chance that the far suns outside our planetary system are nearer than everybody's thinking and everybody's teaching. His idea that the photons of our sun are deflecting the light stream photons of the far sun is based on Einstein's discovery of light being attracted by mass. As a result, the photons of light streams that come from the far sun and pass our sun with a greater distance and finally arrive on Earth are much less deflected than such photons of light streams nearer to a sun. Possible is the height of the triangle of place, which in one case describes the real place of the far sun, we call it triangle of place 1. In the other case, the assumed place of the star our so-called top 2 is extremely changing, and people expect the far sun to be in a different angle, which means the far sun is nearer. Secondly, seeking dark matter concerning the higher velocity of stars rotating inside old galaxies won't probably be successful, which led to Dr. Rüdiger Goltz's second theory that says the gravitational circumstances are changing in the case of old galaxies because of vacuum losing intensity the older a galaxy is. His equation F equals F1 minus F2 is explaining why F has to be big in the case of F2, the power which describes the vacuum force to push a star outward a galaxy being small. Thirdly, planet X is obviously not existing. The circles of astronomical objects within the Kuiper belt can be explained with an amount of still unseen young suns instead. That's what has been found out by Rüdiger Goltz, doctor of philosophy. He exists, as you can see.
In the moment, I am assuming that the situation which just has been explained, the situation of deflection between particles of light, can be explained very easy in the room of three dimensions too. My top theory is culminating in the idea that the deflection between particles of light is a sort of a new law of nature, the law of God, abbreviated LOG, applicable to three dimensions too. LOG can be tested by means of a spaceship surrounding the sun, measuring the true distances to the stars. Optionally, the ISS of our time can measure the effects which maybe is increasing exponentially depending on the distance to Earth.